It was very ambitious. I mean, compared to the first Alien, which was very small and claustrophobic, this was a big, kind of heart-pounding version of Alien.
The budget this movie was slated at, and the movie that they were trying to make was very ambitious.
There was a feeling that we were working on something that was going to be a landmark, and that whatever we had to go through would be worth it.
From the time we're children, we are inherently afraid of that which we don't know and don't understand, but it's also in our nature to be curious and to go into those dark places and look around with a flashlight. But God forbid that flashlight should ever fail. Ridley Scott made this film that I think just stunned the world, and I was one of the people who was stunned by it when I saw it. And a few years later, when I became a filmmaker myself, I actually, saw an opportunity when I was asked to write the second one. To, you know, I wanted to make a film like that. I was so impressed by the world that he created, the characters that he created, and the design. But you know, I think there are many accomplishments in that first film, and he really set the bar very high for science fiction in general.
We had been planning on doing a sequel, I mean, right away. Well, Alan Ladd was there, talking about it already. And then he left, and I think this was when Marvin Davis bought the studio, and there was Norman Levy, who was running it, and Sherry Lansing, I guess. She had less to do with it. It was Norman Levy who was really opposed to it, I was later told. And they just didn't want to do it. And, you know, so we weren't pushing for it. We didn't, you know, we had an idea about how to do it, and we had, you know, thought they should do it, but we didn't think that was really, you know. And finally, there was another change of management and another, you know, new group that came in. And one of them stopped me in the parking lot when he said, oh, I knew him. He said, you guys have been talking about Alien, you know. He said, so what do you want to do? So I kind of told him the story that was a cross between Southern Comfort that Walter and I had made since and The Magnificent Seven that we were working on at the moment. And he said, great, that sounds fine. You know, good. So we all had a meeting, and we were on.
When we were casting Terminator and we found Arnold Schwarzenegger, we were going to start shooting in summer of 1983, and we were going to shoot in Toronto. However, Dino De Laurentiis had a preemptive option on Arnold to star in Conan II, The Destroyer. He'd already made the big hit, Conan the Barbarian, and he preempted Arnold to star in that film, which meant that we couldn't start shooting for about 9 months. Now, that wasn't enough time to do another movie, but it was enough time for Jim to take on a writing assignment.
I had met Jim Cameron because Larry Wilson, who was our head of development, sent me this pile of scripts with a big recommendation for The Terminator. And so I read The Terminator, and I thought it was real good. And then at one point, I think when we really were now looking for a writer on Alien 2, I thought, well, why not him? He'd probably be he knows this movie, back the first one, probably better than I do, backwards and forwards, you know. So I asked him if he wanted to write that, and yeah, he did. And I tried to get Fox then to take an option on him as a director. They didn't. And he, wrote a draft of Alien, and then he went off to make The Terminator.
By the time we started shooting, however, he'd written about 90 pages, and he was still in the second act, and it wasn't a completed script. However, the people at Fox read it and loved it and said, you know what, we're going to do the unthinkable. We're going to wait. We're going to wait until you're available to finish the script. And if your directing debut is, well, it really wasn't a debut in that he'd already directed Prawn to the Spawning, but if this film turns out well and you demonstrate talent in the directing field, we'll also let you direct. I'm not sure they were telling us the truth at the time, but we chose to believe it. We were naive, and I think that in Hollywood, when you're starting out, it helps to be naive and idealistic and believe that people are telling you the truth. And in this case, it turned out to be something that came to pass. If Terminator hadn't been such a success when it premiered, I doubt that Jim would have been brought on to direct.